Good morning, everyone. If you're able, would you please be upstanding as we receive God's word? Please be seated. Richard, can I invite you to come and read the church news?
Good morning, everybody, and welcome to worship here in St. John's this morning. A special welcome to the family and friends of Finn Blair. Hello, Finn, who has been baptised during the service today. Tea and coffee will be served as usual in the Dunn Memorial Hall at the end of the service, and all are invited. A reminder for all elders, there will be a joint meeting of the five Kirk sessions this afternoon at 3 p.m. in St. Columba's Parish Church in Largs. If anyone has any articles for the September edition of the St. John's Bulletin, could they please email them to the editor, Alison Struthers, or pass them to Largs Printing Company by Friday of this week. Safeguarding training will take place in St. Columba's Parish Church next Sunday, the 27th of August, starting at 2:30 p.m. All elders and board members are encouraged to attend. And I have to read this citation to the congregation to appear at Presbytery with regards to the union. Notice is hereby given that Presbytery will consider the basis of union between Cumbrae Parish Church, Fairley Parish Church, Clark Memorial Church Largs, St. Columba's Parish Church Largs, and St. John's Parish Church Largs at the Presbytery meeting on the second day of September 2023 at the Howard Centre, Kilmarnock at 2 p.m. The congregation is cited to attend in its own interests. Thank you, and over to you, Graham. Thank you.
Thank you, Richard, thank you. Whether here in St. John's Parish Church in Largs or online, as we gather, let us worship God. Can I invite you to join with me for our opening scripture? Our opening scripture this morning comes from Psalm 43, and if you're able, let's read these words together. Why am I so sad? Why am I so troubled? I will put my hope in God, and once again I will praise him, my Saviour and my God. So let us turn to praise our Saviour and our God. We sing our first hymn of praise, All My Hope on God Is Founded. Let's collect our thoughts. Let's come before our Lord in a time of quietness, a time of reflection, a time of prayer. Let's enter into communion with our Lord and our God. Let us pray. Lord God Almighty, humbly in this place and wherever we are online, we take this time to be in communion with you, to speak with you, to listen for your word to us. We recognize that upon you our faith is built. And for this we give you praise and thanks. For the blessings of each and every day, we give you praise and thanks. But most of all, for the gift of your precious Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, we give you praise and thanks. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the Father, in true humility we come before you. We offer you our worship and our praise. We dedicate our lives to you. We praise you, Lord Jesus Christ, for your teaching. We praise you for opening our eyes to the great love that God has for each and every one of us. But we also recognize that sometimes we turn our back on that love, when we seek to go our own way. And so today we ask that you would send your Holy Spirit upon us to forgive us from all that separates us from you. Lord, we recognize in our weakness, we often follow others rather than follow you. Opinions of others matter, but Lord, your guidance is where we place our trust. So be with us now. As you forgive us of our sins, we ask that you would unite us as one people, that we may be worthy to be known as Christians, following in the footsteps of Jesus, living our lives to give you glory and honor, seeking to unite and not divide. Bless us now, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, as we come together as one people, wherever we are, and we pray the comforting and familiar words that Jesus has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. I was wondering at the beginning, when everyone was arriving, if we're going to have any members of the Young Church. So it's very, very good to see you here today. Something important happening this next couple of days. Is anything important happening these next few days? No. Does anybody know if there's anything important happening these next few days? Do you not go back to school? Yeah. Is it back to school tomorrow? Oh, how are you feeling? Hands up if you're looking forward to it. Are you not? So what happens when you go back to school? You got new teachers. What's your teacher called? Mr. Shields and Mrs. Hannah. Have you got a teacher? What's your teacher called? So, Miss Hamilton. Do you know, that's really quite interesting, because I didn't always know the name of my teacher when I was going back to school, and sometimes it would be a surprise. Did anybody else feel like that when they went back to school? You were so much in shock. I don't want to go back to school, but you have to. So maybe tomorrow, your teachers may say to you, what do you remember about last time we were at school? What is 6 plus 4? Do you know what that sum is? How many? 10. Fantastic. Whoa, that was a hard one. What is the place in Scotland that's got the big famous castle? Does any of the grown-ups know that? Anybody brave enough to say? Edinburgh, Edinburgh. See, some of these older people were at school as well. It's good that they remembered some things. So you may get asked some questions. Do you know, when we come to church, we come to hear about Jesus. And Jesus had a group of followers, and there was a time that we read of in the Bible, and it was as if they were going back to school. So there was these followers of Jesus, and do you think, who do you think their teacher was? Well, their teacher, and it's interesting because I didn't always know my teacher either, I said that. Their teacher, of course, was Jesus. And Jesus would sometimes teach his followers. And there was one day he said to them, who do people say I am? And teacher might ask you questions, and Jesus was asking his followers questions. And some of them said, some people say you're John the Baptist. But Jesus wasn't John the Baptist. Other people say you're Elijah, and that's a person in the Old Testament, the before Jesus' time, and Jesus wasn't Elijah. And some people said, oh, you're Jeremiah, or one of the other prophets. And none of that was true, because Jesus was Jesus. And then this follower of Jesus called Peter, it was as if he put his hand up and he says, I know. You are Jesus. You are the Messiah, the Son of the living God. And do you know, if that was the only thing he ever learned, that was the best thing to learn. And if it's the only message that we have today, that we learn from today, that's a great lesson to learn. If somebody was to say to you, or you, or you, or you, or me, who is Jesus? And we say, Jesus is the Messiah, the Son of the living God. If we can say that, that's like getting an A. Or if you're in England, an A star. So when you go to school tomorrow, I hope you enjoy it. I hope you're not afraid of your teacher. And I hope you learn lots of things and you can remember things from the last time you were at school. I really hope you enjoy tomorrow as much as your mums and dads. We're going to sing a hymn of praise, which speaks of Jesus. And it speaks of the light of Christ, the love of God shining upon each and every one of us. And the great words are, shine, Jesus, shine. And if you feel that you want to clap, let's clap. Let's give God praise. Shine, Jesus, shine. So before the young church go out, let's ask God's blessing upon them. Loving God, we give you praise and thanks for the young church gathered here before you. In all of their concerns about returning to school, we pray that you'd send your Holy Spirit upon them, that they would know peace and calmness. Be with them now as they go to learn more of your great love. And we look forward to welcoming them back as they come to celebrate in the sacrament of baptism. So be with us now, but be with them and their leaders, for this we ask in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you. So any young people are invited to go out, and you'll come back in for the christening later. So you can go out and play. Any of the older ones want to go and play as well? They're welcome to go out, any young people. You're welcome to remain also. I wonder, with all the changes going on in our church and our country and around the world, is there anyone you really trust to do the best for you? Recently, or maybe not so recently, there seems to be great change in life. A great change from placing our trust in God, well, to placing our trust in ourselves. But that has that been a good change? This week, lots of organizations return. The school, as we mentioned, the Boys Brigade and Girls Brigade, some toddlers groups. And the changes that we observe in society are often reflected in the organizations that we attend. When I was young, I wasn't part of the Boys Brigade. I was a Cub Scout, and then a proper scout, if you know what I mean. And as part of our promise, we spoke of putting our trust in God. We said, on my honor, I promise to do my best, to do my duty to God and to the Queen, as it was then, to help other people and to keep the Scout law. However, through the years, that's changed. No longer do members of the Scouting movement have to pledge their loyalty to God, but instead they can promise to uphold Scouting values or to serve their community. I wonder how you feel about those changes. As a minister, you might wonder how I feel about them. Well, if truth be told, I'm really not that concerned. Yes, it's another erosion of God's name being honoured, which I find very sad. But really, was God's name truly being honoured by those who made the promise to trust in God? Being a former scout, I know that scouting, or guiding for that matter, isn't a faith group. And while many other groups don't mention God in their vows or in their rules, like the golf club or the local school, or even the Scottish Parliament, these groups don't stop men or women of faith joining and honouring God's name through what they do within that organisation. If people don't know God at all, then pledging their allegiance to God is meaningless. But at least now, we can all be honest and not falsely assume that others know the God who created the heavens and the earth. At least now we can be honest and have a specific starting point from which to speak of God. And at least now we can be honest and be open that those who are men and women of faith are not embarrassed to be so. In the world today, I get fed up with people trying to knock our faith. We don't have to apologize that we have faith, even faith the size of a mustard seed. Faith in God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, of which we will profess shortly, is wonderful and fulfilling. Certainly it can be challenging, but I have to be honest and say I don't know how I could live without my faith in the one true God. I wonder if you ever get people trying to justify their lack of faith. They might say things like, well, I don't believe everything you believe, which I just think is a totally wonderful statement, because how could they possibly know what I believe? Because they don't come to church, and they often avoid any suggestion of talking about God. No, I really don't have a problem with changes whereby organizations drop their public affiliation to God. But I do have a problem with those of us who have faith in Jesus Christ apologizing for or being embarrassed with the faith that we have. Our faith is what has made us who we are. The call on the Christian is to have a faith which frees us to live our lives honestly, which allows us to place our entire lives into God's hands. As we read in the Bible, in the book of Proverbs, it says, trust in the Lord with all your heart. To those without faith, our faith in God may seem a little vague, even an airy-fairy concept, because they don't understand what faith in God means. They don't see that our faith is about placing our complete trust in the supreme God who is all around us. Let's hear a short passage from the prophet Isaiah, which recognizes the difficulty humanity has in a secular environment. But it's also a short passage which speaks of a day which is coming when everyone will trust in the Lord and say, I praise you, Lord. Thank you, Susan.
From Isaiah chapter 12. In that day, you will say, I will praise you, O Lord. Although you were angry with me, your anger has turned away and you have comforted me. Surely God is my salvation. I will trust and not be afraid. The Lord is my strength and my song. He has become my salvation. With joy you will draw water from the wells of salvation. In that day you will say, give thanks to the Lord, call on his name, make known among the nations what he has done, and proclaim that his name is exalted. Sing to the Lord, for he has done glorious things. Let this be known to all the world. Shout aloud and sing for joy, people of Zion, for great is the Holy One of Israel among you. Amen. And may God add his blessing to the reading of his holy word.
Thank you, Susan. The Lord himself is my strength and my defense. Trust is the practical outworking of our faith. And it's when we trust God and we show that our faith in him is real and not open to abuse or manipulation by others. As I said, I don't really have a problem with organizations not promising to place their trust in God. But I do have a concern with what members of these organizations are replacing this trust in God with, promising to be true to oneself. And the reason for that concern is quite simple. Throughout the world, there are millions of people whose trust is misplaced. In this messy world of challenge and change, unfortunately, doing things on our own is the problem, not the solution. Just look at Russia and Ukraine. Just look at Britain and the European Union, and even Scotland and the United Kingdom. When we place our trust in ourselves, it's an act of selfishness. It has to be. And it's always at the cost of others. Today we have an opportunity to share our faith in God honestly with those around us, expressing and displaying our trust in the sovereign God, whose love and care is evident to those who have eyes to see and ears to hear. For too long, we have been believing that others are teaching about God and Jesus, his Son. But now we have to take responsibility for the faith we have. And the command which Jesus gave us, which was to go to all people everywhere. Whatever changes are around us, as a church, as a country, as the world, take heart and know that Christ is with us as we share the good news with those around us. And today, we can be reassured that, as the prophet Isaiah reminds us, a day is coming when all people will place their trust in God and sing, "Give thanks to the Lord." However, until that day comes, we must all continue to place our trust in God. Because placing our trust in ourselves can be so misplaced. Amen. It's easy to fool ourselves and think we're always doing right, but if we don't have the marker of our Lord, gosh, we can do lots of things. And actually, hasn't history shown that humanity does lots of things contrary to God's will? But one of the things that we can do is listen to our Lord Jesus Christ, who told his people to go to all places everywhere and baptize them in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. And so let us take a step towards that wonderful sacrament of baptism. We're going to sing a hymn to God's glory. The words may not be familiar, the tune will be. And during this hymn of praise, our offerings will be uplifted.
Thank you.
So let's dedicate these thank offerings. And for those who were seeking money for an offering, you can place them in here later. But let's dedicate them to God's glory. Loving and eternal Father, for the opportunity to return to you some of the blessings you first give to us, we give you praise and thanks. For the offerings presented before you, in this money and in our lives, we ask that you would bless for the work of your kingdom, here in Largs, but across the country. Bless us now as we enter a time of sacramental blessing. Receive all that we offer through Jesus, your Son. Amen. So this morning we welcome Finn, but Finn is Finn Stuart Gordon Blair. We welcome his dad and mum. We welcome Brian and Elaine. And we welcome family and friends who are joining with us as Finn comes to be presented for baptism. Finn is coming to be baptized to receive the gift of God's Holy Spirit. Finn will be anointed with the Holy Spirit in the same way that many of us here today were anointed when we were young. In baptism, Finn is assured of the love of God for him, and the sign and the seal of God's Holy Spirit will be placed upon him. Jesus said, "Full authority in heaven and earth have been given to me. Go therefore to all nations and make them my disciples. Baptize them in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, and teach them to observe all that I have commanded you. I will be with you always to the end of time." Jesus also called the children and said, "Let the children come to me. Do not try to stop them, for the kingdom of God belongs to such as these. And no one can enter the kingdom of God without being born of water and the Holy Spirit." So as Jesus welcomes the children, Jim, I wonder if you'd like to go and see if the young church are able to come through. When you come. Finn is very much a people watcher. He's calmed down a little bit, maybe getting tired. Great to see you. No, great to see you. You're okay? No, thank you. Thank you for coming back. Okay. Thanks, Jim. Thank you. So we come to the point in our service for the young churches joined us for the baptism of Finn. When Jesus was baptized in the waters of the River Jordan, the Spirit of God came upon him. And Jesus' baptism was completed through his dying and his rising again. And so our baptism is a sign of dying to sin and rising to newness of life. It is Christ himself who baptizes us. By his Holy Spirit, he makes us members of his body, the church, and he calls us to share in his ministry in the world. By water, which we have here, and the Holy Spirit, God claims us to be his own. He washes us from sin, and he sets us free from the power of death. And in this sacrament, the love of God is offered to each one of us, not just to Finn, to each one of us, though we can't understand it or even explain it. All we are asked to do is to accept that blessing with the trust of a child. In our faith, we profess an understanding, a belief in God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. So can I ask for the words of the Apostles' Creed to come upon the wall? And just please, just remain seated. Let's profess our faith together, if you're able to do so, by reading these words together. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Elaine and Brian and Sinead and Derek, can I invite you to come up? Do you want to stand up in this area here? If you want to maybe, yeah, Derek, you go into the back. So yeah, no, that's it. Brian, you go there and Derek's at the back. That's good. Okay. That means everyone can see you and you can see everyone and everyone can see Finn. Elaine and Brian, Sinead and Derek, in presenting Finn for baptism, desiring that he may be grafted into Christ as a member of his body, the church, do you receive the teaching of the Christian faith which we have just professed in the Apostles' Creed? Let's come before our Lord in prayer. We thank you, gracious God, for your gifts of water and the Holy Spirit. Send your Holy Spirit upon us and upon this water, that Finn, being buried with Christ in baptism, may rise with him to newness of life, and being born anew of water and the Holy Spirit, may remain forever in the number of your faithful children. For this we ask through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be all honor and glory, now and forever. Amen. I'll take Finn now. My microphone will be live. If Finn shouts out, you'll be deafened. But he's been great. Hey. Oh. He's much lighter than my boys were at that age, I was just saying. Hey, Finn, can you see everyone? Finn, for you, Jesus Christ came into the world. For you, he lived and showed God's love. For you, he suffered the darkness of Calvary and cried at the last, "It is accomplished." For you, he triumphed over death and rose to newness of life. And for you, he ascended to reign at God's right hand. All this he did for you, Finn, so that the word of Scripture is fulfilled. We love because God first loved us. Finn, Stuart, Gordon Blair, I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. May the blessing of God the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit descend upon you and remain with you this day and forever. Amen. There is a blessing that we sing at church, and I'm going to ask Derek if he would play, and the words will be on the screen. Let's sing to God's glory and our blessing. Perfect. Perfect. Will I give you back to Mummy? There you are. Finn is now baptized into Jesus Christ, and we receive and welcome him as a member of the one Holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. Elaine and Brian, Sinead and Derek, Finn now belongs to God in Christ. From this day, he will be at home within the Christian community, and there will always be a place for him. Tell Finn of his baptism, and as you continue to find the treasures of Christ, tell Finn of the treasures that he has been given today, so that he may know that he is baptized. And as he grows, makes his own response in faith and love, and come in due time to share in the communion of the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. Elaine and Brian, Sinead and Derek, do you promise, depending on the grace of God, to teach Finn the truths and duties of the Christian faith, and by prayer and example, to bring him up in the life and in the worship of the Church? You who are gathered here represent the whole Christian Church. Word and sacrament bring to us all the joy of Christ's presence in our midst, but they also bring responsibilities as Christ's people in this place. Therefore, can I ask if you are able, please, to stand? And to my question, I ask you only to respond if you're prepared to take this responsibility. Do you welcome Finn? And do you renew your commitment with God's help to live before all God's children in a kindly and Christian way and to share with them the knowledge and the love of Christ? Please be seated. Let's take a moment before our Lord in prayer. God of love, we rejoice again to receive your grace in word and sacrament. We have heard your call and are made new by your Spirit. Guide and guard Finn all his days. May your love hold him, your truth guide him, your joy delight him. Bless his family that he may grow up in a secure and happy home. Give to him wisdom and courage, laughter and peace, and a love that endures all things. God of grace, in whose church there is one Lord, one faith, one baptism, help us to acknowledge that Jesus Christ is Lord, to profess with our whole lives the one true faith, and to live in love and unity with all who are baptized in his name. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and is worshipped and glorified, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Now, if you wait a second, I think we may have something from the young church. Would you like to come? A gift from the young church, but from the people of St. John's. Okay, and one final part. And can I'll present it to you, Brian. It's Finn's baptismal certificate. So now the Bible that you've been given is not a precious article, okay? It's not to be put in a cupboard. The secret to Scripture is within the pages. And if you can read these pages to Finn, to Noah, okay, and reveal the love of God to them, that's what it's about. The Bible can get torn pages or anything. It's the stories that are precious, not the book. Can I invite you to take Finn, who's the newest member here at St. John's, to return to sit with everyone? And Finn being the newest member, of course, our prayer is, as I mentioned, that in due course, Finn, with Noah, in years to come, will come to our Lord and share in the body and blood of Christ at communion. But today, for Finn, for all of us in the sacrament of baptism, a new day has begun. So as we come towards the close of our time here together at worship, let us give God the glory as we recognize that morning has broken. So go from this place. Continue on with your days. Continue to answer the question, if asked, who is Jesus? Recognizing that he is the Christ, the Son of the living God. And go from this place to enjoy life with the blessing of God Almighty, God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, one God, now and always. Amen. Thank you, Jim. Okay.